So what exactly can remove the presumptions or the protections found under the Florida Castle Doctrine law? According to Florida Statute 776.013, subsection 3, the presumption granted under the law can be eliminated in four ways. The first way the presumptions can be eliminated is if the person who entered your dwelling, residence, or occupied vehicle has a legal right to be there. Florida Statute 776.013, subsection 3, subsection A. The person against whom the defensive force is used or threatened has the right to be in or is a lawful resident of the dwelling, residence, or vehicle, such as an owner, lessee, or title holder, and there is not an injunction for protection from domestic violence or a written pretrial supervision order of no contact against that person. So the second way the presumptions can be eliminated is if the person being removed is a child or grandchild and the person removing the child or grandchild has lawful custody. Here's what it says. The person or persons sought to be removed is a child or grandchild or is otherwise in lawful custody or under lawful guardianship of the person against whom the defensive force is used or threatened. So if Tiffany and I were ever to get separated and I decided to swing by the house and pick up one or all of my children, Tiffany would not have a legal right to use or threaten the use of a gun because I have just as much legal right to take my children as she does. Now, obviously, this would only apply if we had joint custody and no restraining orders. So the third way that these presumptions can be eliminated is if the person who uses or threatens to use deadly force is engaging in criminal activity. Here's what the law says. The person who uses or threatens to use defensive force is engaged in a criminal activity or is using the dwelling, residence, or occupied vehicle to further a criminal activity. Now, obviously, if you're making meth in your garage, yes, I'm speaking to you, Sefner, then you do not have a right to use or threaten the use of deadly force. The final way that the presumptions can be eliminated is if the person against whom the defensive force was used was a law enforcement officer. Here's what the Florida statutes say. The person against whom the defensive force is used or threatened is a law enforcement officer, as defined in Florida Statute 943.10, subsection 14, who enters or attempts to enter a dwelling, residence, or vehicle in the performance of his or her duties. And the officer identified himself or herself in accordance with any applicable law, or the person using or threatening to use force knew or reasonably should have known that the person entering or attempting to enter was a law enforcement officer. Now, it should go without saying, but you never have the right to use a firearm against a law enforcement officer.